Push in it.
Yeah.
But what Lisa was asking me about was shoes. Now, the shoe company shoe companies have done a fantastic job at selling us extremely expensive, chunky sole shoes for years and years and years, and it's in their best interest that we continue to believe that. To a certain extent, for some people, those kinds of shoes are still the best option. And if you've been wearing those kinds of shoes all your life, then any sudden change would be bad, and if you did make a change, it would have to be over a period of time. A little bit of a different shoe, but then the old shoe for quite a while until you replace them out. But when you're in the bone clinic, we want to get as much force through your body as possible. And if you put in a big chunky soft wedge on your shoe, you're absorbing half of that. So the best thing you can do, I'm looking around the room, these, I know these don't look like the world's most fantastic sports shoes, but those are not bad shoes for this gym. You know, you go into a sportswear shop and they'll just go, oh, they're so bad for your feet. But in here, they're okay. There are shoes called minimal shoes and barefoot shoes. I'm sure you've all seen those really ugly five finger, they're actually five toe shoes. Those ones are perfectly fine in here. In fact, you know, if you didn't have to be careful about health and safety, bare feet would be fine. But you want to be careful that you're not picking up any germs or stubbing your toe or dropping anything on your foot. So it's good to have some kind of foot covering. But the less wedge you have on your shoe, the better. You're not going to wear a pair of business shoes, you know, these are office shoes, but you could actually get away with that. The flatter, the better. Because as soon as you put a little bit of a heel on, it actually shortens that Achilles tendon a little bit. You